Sorry, 1 minute. Right. Okay, last 2 weeks ago, we spoke about the neder of Yiftach. Okay, so let's go through the psukim. Okay, the psukim say the following. The sentences say the following. Vatehi al Yiftach, Ruach Hashem, vayavor et Gilad, et Gilad beit Menashe, vayavor et Mitzpeh Gilad, u'Mitzpeh Gilad avar bnei Amon. And then Yida Yiftach Neder Hashem, and he says to them, if HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give you Bnei Amon Biyadi, and then anybody who comes out, the first person who comes out from the Dalte Beiti, Likrat Shuvi, I will offer him a person Olah. And last week, 2 weeks ago, we spoke about the opinion of the Abra Benel, and that's what's written in front of you in line number 30. V'neidat Chazal b'inyan hazeu, that in actual fact, she was offered up as a sacrifice. But the Abra Benel doesn't agree with that. And the Abra Benel claims that in actual fact, she became like a nun in a convent, all by herself, etc., etc., etc. Now, what I'm going to learn with you now is, in actual fact, the sources of Chazal. The sources of Chazal in line number 45. There's a Midrash Tanchuma. The Midrash Tanchuma on Sefer Parshat Bechukotai and Sefer Vayikra. Davar Acher, Ish Kiyafli, Neder Berkaot Nafshot, Berkacha Nafashot. If a person will decide to offer up his value of his soul, we know there's a special law in the laws of Korbanot, that a person can give the value of his soul, the value of his body, to the Beit HaMikdash. Say Chazal, Zeo Shekatav, this is what's written, Pri Tzadik Etz Chaim, the fruit of a Tzadik Etz Chaim, V'lokeach Nefashot Chacham. But somebody who takes a soul is a wise guy. Now, what does this mean? So Chazal, the rabbis want to say the following. Line number 47. Im yeyeh adam tzadik, if a person is a tzadik, afal pi shehu tzadik, ve'eino osek b'Torah and doesn't learn Torah, ein biyado klum, he doesn't have anything. That means a person can keep as many mitzvot in his life and he doesn't sit and learn Torah. Come on, it doesn't mean anything. So what does it mean? Ela pri tzadik etz chayim ze Torah, shemitoch shehu ben Torah, since he knows Torah, hu lamad ech lokeach nefashot. How can he give the value of his soul? Sheneemar velokeach nefashot chacham. Sheim yadur, if a person makes a neder, a vow, la'aroch nefashot, hu lamad Torah, ech oseh. V'im ein biyado Torah, and if he doesn't know anything, then ein biyado klum. Kein ata motse b'yiftach hagiladi. This is what we find concerning Yiftach. Mipnei shelo haya ben Torah. He wasn't a ben Torah. He didn't know how to use language properly. He didn't have the Torah way of looking at language. Avad et bito. Ibed et bito. He lost his daughter. Eimatai. When did this take place? B'shah shenilcham im bnei Amon. V'nadar ba'ota sha'a sh'ne'emar v'yidar yiftach neder v'haya yotze v'haya al Hashem v'elitiu ola ba'ota sha'a. Haya alav kas min HaKadosh Baruch Hu. HaKadosh Baruch Hu was angry with him. Amar, ilu yatsa mi beito kelev o chazir o gamal haya makriv oto. If a dog or a chaza or a camel would have come out from his house, he would have sacrificed it, he would have said such a thing. That means, before he comes and says, whatever comes out of my house, I will sacrifice, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says to him, think, what could have happened? Let's say a dog would have come out. Did you think if a dog would have come out, you'd offer him a sacrifice? Obviously not. If a chaza would have come out, would he have offered up a sacrifice? So Chazal say, since Yiftach didn't take into consideration all of the possibilities which could take place, HaKadosh Baruch Hu zimen lo bito. He appointed his daughter. That means HaKadosh Baruch Hu says to a person, every single word which a person says has an application, has a consequence. Before a person opens his mouth, think of all the consequences which can take place because of what he said. Yiftach, did you take responsibility? Did you realize the consequences of your word? No, you didn't. Say Chazal, kol kach lama, kedei sheilamdu kol hanodrim. Anybody who makes a vow or anything which a person says, hilchot nedarim v'konamot, the laws of vows, shelo linhog ta'ut binedarim. A person shouldn't make any mistakes in what he says. So Yiftach now becomes the example of a person who didn't think before he spoke. He didn't think before he made a promise. He didn't think before he actually says what he says. And Chazal say, Nachon, he offered up his daughter as a sacrifice, like Yitzchok, like Avram would have done to Yitzchok. And that's how the Ramban explains the story. Says the Ramban, V'od matzati be'agada b'yelamdeinu. We found a midrash. Tanya Rabbi Akiva Omer, Hacherem hu ashvua. If a person makes a promise, it's like an oath. V'ashvua icherem. Anshei Yavesh, we won't go into this story, we'll do that later. In line number 63. V'zeh haya ta'uto shel Yiftach b'vito. Ki chashav, kasher charam negid Yisrael. When the prince of Israel makes a promise, makes a cherem, chal v'kayam la'amit anashim, if he makes a promise that he's going to kill somebody, or over al charmo chayav mita, ken im nadar, if a person makes a promise, be'et milchama, la'asot me'ish o anashim zevach, if a person makes a vow at the time of the war to make a certain person or people a sacrifice, yachula neder, v'lo yada, and Yiftach didn't know, ki cherem hamelech, a person who makes a cherem, an excommunication by the king, chal al amordim lechalotam, or al over al gzeratam. That, Rabotai, is the explanation. Says the Ramban, v'al tiye nifte, don't be surprised by the nonsense which Eben Ezra says, behavle Rabbi Avraham, that means he didn't mean actually a sacrifice. He'll be like a convent. And if the thing will be befitting to sacrifice, to offer up as a sacrifice, then he'll do it. Says the Ramban, no. The Ramban says what Chazal say were correct, and in actual fact, according to Chazal, this girl, his daughter, was offered up as a sacrifice. That's the Ramban's explanation. That means Yiftach was guilty of not thinking of all the consequences. That's stage number one, and this is how the Ramban understands the story. Eben Ezra and the Abrabanel understand it differently. But now we'll go into the story of why, of what actually happens. Say Chazal, line number 79. V'halo, Pinchas haya sham. Pinchas was there. That means who was the head of the high priest? Pinchas. Pinchas was the high priest. Hu omer, lo ochal lashuv. I can't go there. Ela Pinchas Amar, Ani Kohen Gadol, Ben Kohen Gadol. I am the high priest, the son of a high priest. I'm the son of Aaron HaKohen. V'ani elech etzel ha'maretz. I'm going to go to an Amoretz to go and speak to him. Yiftach omer, ani Rosh Shoftei Yisrael. I'm the boss. Rosh HaKtzinim. Ashpil atzmi ve'elech etzel hedyot. And I'm going to go to an ordinary person. Raboisai, a battle of ego. A battle of pride. And between them, mibein travaihun, and between these two people, avda hahi alufta mina olam. That poor girl lost her life. Whether she lost her life physically, lost her life emotionally, lost her life spiritually, that's what happened. Ego. What ego causes in a machloikas. And nothing to do with halacha. Simply two people, each one isn't willing to give up on his covered. Ushnehem, and between them, nitchayvu bedameha. Both of these people were liable for a punishment. Pinchas, nistalek mimenu ruach hakodesh. Because of this, Pinchas lost his Holy Spirit. Yiftach, nitpazru atzmotav. His bones were scattered all over the place. Sheken k'tiv, vayikaver, and he was buried ba'arei Gilad, in many cities of Gilad. Here, Rabotai, we have the battle of honor. The battle of honor. Now, in order to understand this in a deeper way, okay, what is the problem here? The problem basically is Yiftach is connected to the tribe of Menashe. Now, Menashe has always been the secondary one. Now let's take the psyche of the tribe of Menashe. Menashe, in actual fact, is the person who, in a way, lost being the Bechor, the firstborn. Because we know, what does Yaakov do when he blesses Ephraim and Menashe? He crosses his hands. Right. Now, he crosses his hands, but on the other hand, says the Netziv, and we've already spoken about this before, he doesn't move them over one side to the other. Why does he cross his hands? Why does he put his right hand on Ephraim's head, who was standing on his left side? And why does he put the left hand on Menashe, who's standing on his right side? Surely he should have put Menashe on his left side and Ephraim on his right side. Why just cross his hands? Says the Netziv in line number 85. Sikel et yadav, ki Menashe habechor. He crosses his hands because Menashe is the firstborn. Says the Netziv, umiyutar. This is extra. Sherei yadanu meinyan ha-parsha ki Menashe ha-bechor. Aval yesh beze omek v'kavana. De be'emet, lo haya. Lo haya le-Yaakov le-sakel yadav. Ela lehafoch et ma'amad abanim. He should have changed them around. Aval ba'asher Menashe ha-bechor, since Menashe is the firstborn, mishum hachi. Because of this, haya mechaven sheyamod Menashe leregel hayimini. He wanted Menashe to be on his right-hand side. Ephraim leregel smol. He wanted Menashe to be on his right leg and Ephraim on his left leg. V'rak az et yadav sikel. V'ta'amo shel davar, she'af al gav she'igdim Yaakov et Ephraim lifnei Menashe, u'mishum hachi, because of this, Ephraim was the main tribe. Mikol makom, bipkudei in the counting of Parshat Pinchas, aya lehefech, it was the other way around. Velo od, and even more so, afilo bipkudei de Parshat Bamidbar katuv b'chol adganim v'achonim alav, mashen kei menashe. Kol zeba, all this teaches us, shelo aya Ephraim kodim lemnashe, ela b'inyanim ruchaniim. The only extra stance, the extra spirit which Ephraim had was a spiritual one. Mashelemala, which was above norm, aval ba'alichot olam, haya menashe kodem, v'gadol mi'Ephraim. Menashe and Ephraim both had special gifts. Menashe had the physical side, and Ephraim have the spiritual side. This was the bracha which Yaakov gives to Ephraim. Now Menashe, who Yiftach was their leader, he feels that as far as I'm concerned, I in the natural world, I am the boss. Menashe fights Shevet Levi, because Levi thinks that they're the boss in the spiritual world. Who's going to bend down to whom? Menashe is going to bend down to Levi, or Levi is going to bow down to Menashe? Now this, Rabotai, is the constant tension which Rabbi Sachs often speaks about, the division of power. The division of power in the Jewish religion, there are four different parts of power. Power is divided into four sections: prophecy, a Navi, a Melech, the king, Sanhedrin, the law courts, and the final one is priesthood, Kohen Gadol. We just had this huge argument now in Israel. Who's the boss of the Knesset? The law courts or the speaker? The division of power. Division of power is a massive problem. How to balance out all these things? Now, in a normal world where you have normal people or good people, then each one knows the correct balance. Take, for instance, David HaMelech. David HaMelech sins. The prophet comes to him and he tells him, you sinned with Bathsheba. David HaMelech doesn't say to the prophet, go to hell, I'm the boss, I'm the king. But he says, no. In spiritual matters, David HaMelech becomes subservient to the prophet, etc., etc., etc. That means the balance of power always needs personalities who know where their place is. In a situation of Yiftach, we have two people who don't know the correct balance of power. Yiftach says, Pinchas, you've got to come to me. Pinchas says, Yiftach, you have to come to me. And what happens? The girl dies. What should have really happened? You should have had a situation where you meet on neutral ground. Each one goes and finds a place where it's in the middle and they both speak together. That means to say, each one has got to give up a little bit of his power. Each one wasn't willing to give up a little bit of his covered. Nothing. Right. That's the first explanation of Chazal. Now we're going to go to the extra explanation of Chazal. Come along, Chazal, and the Navi tells us the following story. After the story of Yiftach, we have an extra story. It says the following, chapter 12. Vayitzak, vayitzaek ish Ephraim. The tribe of Ephraim start going givalt, givalt. We're going crazy. Vayavo tzafona, and they went up north. Vayomru li Yiftach, madua avarta lilachem bivnei Amon. Why did you go and fight bnei Amon? Velanu lo karata lalechet imcha. You didn't call us. Oh, now here we've got Ephraim coming towards Menashe. And Ephraim have a claim, why didn't you call us to fight? Beitcha Nisrof alecha be'esh. Because you didn't call us, we're now going to burn your house down. Right. Vayomer yiftach alehem. Ish riv hayiti ani ubnei amon mo'od. We, Menashe, who was on the other side of the Jordan, where Transjordan is now, we were having a fight with Amon. Ve'ezak etchem. And I did call you. Ve'lo shatem oti mi'adam, and you never came towards me. Va'ere, and I saw. Ki encha moshia, you don't come towards me. Ve'asima nashi b'chapi, and I put my soul, my body in my hands. Ve'evda el b'nei Amon. Ve'yitnem Hashem b'yadi. Ve'lama lo alitem, ve'lama alitem elai hayom hazeh lilachem bi. Why now are you coming against me? Raboisai, a story of covered. Again, honor. Ephraim come to Menashe and says, we're the most important tribe. You should have called us to fight. It says, Yiftach, I called you. You didn't answer. The fact that Ephraim didn't instigate the war, that was already a pegia in the covert of Ephraim. Vayikbots Yiftach et kol anshei Gilad. Yiftach gets together and all the people of Gilad. Vayeilachem et Ephraim. And they fight with the tribe of Ephraim. Rabbi said, it's like we're talking about two little kids fighting with one another. Ve'ebra v'yaku anshei Gilad et Ephraim. And the people of Gilad smote the people of Ephraim. Why? Ki amru, because they said, next stage, what happens? Ki amru plitei Ephraim atem Gilad betoch Ephraim betoch Menashe. You have come into the tribe, into our area. You are refugees. You got no place amongst us. Ephraim, get out of our country. Get out of ourselves. Vayilkod Gilad et ma'brot ha'yarden le'Ephraim. And Gilad captured all the parts of Ephraim. Vayak yomru plitei Ephraim. And when the plitei Ephraim evora, vayomru l'anshei av Gilad Ephrati ata vayomer lo. What happens? All the people who were refugees from the battle and who were still living, who were from the tribe of Ephraim, were all trying to get back to the other side of the Jordan, onto the main side of Ephraim. And the people of Menashe stopped them. And they said, Vayomru lo, and they said to them, Emono Shibolet. Please say the word Shibolet. Now the tribe of Ephraim couldn't say the letter Shin. They had a lisp. And they could only say Sibolet. That means every shin was in actual fact a sin. They had very bad lisps. And that way, the tribe of Menashe knew if who was from Ephraim and who's from Menashe. Anybody who could say the word Shibolet was okay. Anybody who said the word Sibolet, they knew it was from the tribe of Ephraim. V'yamru Sibolet. V'lo yachlu ledaber ken. V'yachzu oto. And they captured him. Vayishchateu el ma'brot ha'yarden, and they slaughtered them on the borders of the Jordan. Vayipol ba'et ha'im me'Ephraim, 42,000 aleph. 42,000 people from the tribe of Ephraim were slaughtered in that battle. Raboisai, can we believe it that because of honor, because of kavod, that Ephraim, Menashe didn't call Ephraim to fight for them. Ephraim took it badly. They went to fight with Menashe. 42,000 people were killed. Vayishpot Yiftach et Yisrael, and Yisrael and Yiftach judged the people of Israel 6 shanim, 6 years. Vayamot Yiftach Hagiladi, Vayikaver Ba'arei Hagiladi. And he was buried in all the different cities of Gilad. That, Rabotai, is a story which is in consequence to the first story of Yiftach. Now, when does this take place? According to Chazal, the following. Kivan Shirata, the daughter of Yiftach. This takes place, if you remember correctly, for 2 months or two months, the daughter of Yiftach goes away with her friends. We learned that in the last chapter. כיוון שראתה שלא שמע לה, אמרה לה, הניחי לי. She says to them, she says to יפתח, הניחי, leave me, וארד אצל בזדין, and let me go to the Sanhedrin. Now we go to the law courts. According to Chazal, Pinchas and Yiftach fight. Now she goes to the other balance of power, the law courts. And the daughter herself goes down to the law courts. Shema yimtzu petach lindidracha. Shenemar, harpe mimeni shnaim chodoshim, va'elech v'yaradti el harim. And I will go down to the mountains. Amar Rabbi Zecharia, v'chi yesh adam yored el harim. What does he mean, you go down to the mountains? V'ale b'na'alo b'nei adam olim leharim. You go up to the mountains. Mai v'yaradta el harim. What does it mean that she went down? Eilo asanhedrin. K'ma she'ne'emar shimu harim et riv Hashem. Halcha etzlam. She went there. V'lo matzu petach liyiftach ulatir lo et nidro ba'avon otam she'shachat mishevet Ephraim. The Sanhedrin, HaKadosh Baruch Hu took, so to speak, the power of judgment away from the Sanhedrin. They couldn't find any loophole in the vow of Yirmiyahu. And why does HaKadosh Baruch Hu take away the power of judgment, their inability to see the correct way of doing HaTorah Nedarim for the power of Yiftach? Because Yiftach kills 42,000 people from the tribe of Ephraim. Say Chazal, Balav Omer, Gever Rash V'Oshek Dalim. A poor person, okay, is a powerful person, and he's Oshek. He takes away all the money of poor people. Matar Sochef, comes along rain, V'Ein Lechem. Gever Rash V'Oshek Dalim. Ze Yiftach. Shaya Rash B'Torah. Ki Grofo Shel Shikma. He was very poor in Torah, like the base of a very big tree. Shaya Oshek Dalim. He took away all the pride of the poor people. Shneema vayomru lo emono shibolet vayomru sibolet. Velo yachlu ledaber ken. Vaya shochtam. And he slaughtered them. Now these people were refugees. If they were refugees, why kill them? It wasn't in the battle. No, Rabotai, it wasn't in the battle. These people came. They wanted to go back to their house. They were soldiers. They're prisoners of war. Let them go home. Yiftach says, no, guys, we're killing you all off. Ve'ein lechem. Rifichach matar sofech ve'ein lechem. Ve'ein lechem shaya lo mi sheyatir et nidro. Ve'ein lechem shelim hakadosh baruch hu mehem et ha'alacha shelo yimtzu'u. Pitcho latir nidro. HaKadosh Baruch Hu takes away the spirit of the Sanhedrin in order not to find a way of solving the vow of Yiftach. So here, Rabotai, another balance of power. When a leader or anybody doesn't have rachmanut, when a leader doesn't have the ability to see the needs of his nation, then he falls to pieces. And that's what Chazal say in the next pasuk. Let's read the explanation. Dayan, geverash, a poor person, voshek dalim, ve'en, voshek dalim, matar sochef ve'en lechem. Says Rashi, Dayan am haaretz, a leader who's an am haaretz, oshek dalim. He takes away, he usurps the poor people. Bedin al she'eno matun bedin, because he doesn't think. Hareu k'matar, it's like a rain which sochef et hasadeh, causes the field to disappear. Ve'ein oseh peirot, and he doesn't do any fruit. And Rabotai, that is the explanation of this story of Yiftach. Let's read the Midrash about it. Says the Midrash, נתקבצו אליו אנשי אפרים לעשות עם ריבה. The people of Ephraim come together and make an argument. You should have asked Pinchas to matir his neder. Lo batem, ela lasot meriva batem. You've only come to make a fight. Ela, who, Pinchas, lo micha bivnei Ephraim. Pinchas should have warned the people of Ephraim, don't interfere. He didn't. Pinchas is the Kohen Gadol. What should he have done? If it was like his father, Ohev Shalom v'Rodef Shalom, what should he have done? He hears that Ephraim want to fight with Yiftach. What should he have done? Ephraim, leave it. Leave it alone. Don't get involved. Tell Ephraim, keep quiet. It's not your battle. Yiftach saved his tribe. Finished. Yafet. Pinchas doesn't follow what his father did. And since he didn't stop Ephraim from going there, v'uloitir et nidro liftach, and therefore HaKadosh Baruch Hu also doesn't allow him to matir the neder. How each action creates consequences. Yiftach's speech, his vow, creates consequences. Pinchas, who's the Kohen Gadol, should have thought what to do. HaKadosh Baruch Hu takes him away. Yoshev al kiseh shofet tzedek. Yehi shmo ha-gadol mevorach l'olam ul me'olamim. Acharei sham sam ze nafsho bekapo. Uba lahatzil et Yisrael mibnei Amon u-Moav. Uba u-lasot imo meriva. Miad amad. Va'arag mehem shnayim v'arobim elef. Shneemar emar no shibolet v'amar no sibolet. Ze lashon al ze ka'adam shomer l'chavero. Sabel, umi aragotam, Pinchas. Who's the one who is responsible for everything? One person, Pinchas. Pinchas Rabotai is the guilty one who, in actual fact, is guilty for everything. Why? Haya safek biado limchot velo micha. He should have protested to tribe of Ephraim to what? Not to go to war. Ulahatir, and also he should have given up on his own ego. Latir lo nidro liyiftach velo itir. V'chol mi shesafek biado limchot. Chazei chazal from this. Anybody who has the ability to protest, ve'ino moche, lachzir et Yisrael l'mutav, to bring back Am Yisrael to do tshuva, ve'ino machzir, kol damim shenishbachim b'Yisrael, all the blood which is spilt in Am Yisrael, nishpachim al yado. They are poured out, the blood is really poured out by that person. Say Chazal, Pinchas Raboisai is the arch criminal in this story. The arch criminal. He has the ability to follow his father, to mevater on his honor. He doesn't. He doesn't stop the tribe of Ephraim fighting. He doesn't mevater on his kavod to go to Yiftach. So here we have a sliding door. How each action creates consequences. The story of Yiftach is one of the most amazing stories because it teaches us consequences. It teaches us results. How man has to know how to speak. How a man has to know if he's put in a certain position, like Pinchas, who's the Kohen Gadol, he has responsibilities. Pinchas doesn't show his responsibility, then finished. Everything falls to pieces. Now let's do the summary of the story of Yiftach in the eyes of the Ralbag. Rabbi Levi ben Gershom, one of the great Jewish philosophers in the 13th century, wrote a fascinating explanation on the Torah. And after every story in the Tanakh, he summarizes it and what he calls the To'elet. What does this story teach us? What's the objective of these stories in the Tanakh? And why does Shmuel tell the stories of these people? And now we're going to see four objectives. First one is line number 145. Hachamishi, The fifth reason for telling these stories, Hulodia, Sheraoi la'adam, it is befitting for a person, Sheyase in yanav b'chokhma, whatever a person does, he's going to do it b'chokhma, uvehityashvut, and patience, and thinking out things, what we call in modern Hebrew, yishuv hadat. You have a way of thinking, a correct way of thinking. Are you thinking objectively? Are you thinking in a correct way? Kedei shelo tasigeu al ze acharata, that he shouldn't be sorry after he did something. Halotir e kiftach miher lindor neder lashem. Yiftach ran and made a neder. Lashem. Bezulat hityashvut, without doing it, b'yishuv hadat. V'hasigoto acharata. And all of a sudden he becomes, after they become sorry what he did. Ki haya ra'oi sheyityashev t'chila. Think before you do something. Think before you say something. Im haya sheteitzei bito midaltei beito, that perhaps his daughter would come out, zikrato. Sheyikadesh l'ashem davar acher zulata, v'lo yimna mimena pribatet. And not, now he explains like the Abrabanel, that what? That in actual fact, she never got married and she never had children. So the first toilet of this story is, number one, think before you say. Think before you do something. Don't rush and make promises. Don't rush and do things. First, one objective. Second objective, hulodia. Shera'ui lemi shemevakesh tov, ma she'Hashem yitbarach she'ido lo neder. That means if HaKadosh Baruch Hu, if you want to do something good and you want to make a neder, you want to make a neder. But on the other hand, kedei lefarsem belev ha'anashim, ki kol hatovot me'ito. Ulezeh zachar ki yiftach nadar l'Hashem im yiten b'nei amon b'yado. Yiftach did a correct thing. He made a promise. He wanted to do something. He wanted to do something for the sake of Hashem. Now in the time of Corona or any tzarot, what does a person do? He wants to give more tzedakah. Aye, but be careful. Be careful. Don't come and say, I want to give tzedakah of a huge amount of money when you know the markets are going down. Because what will happen then? You lose your money. So that means, on the one hand, Yiftach did a good thing. He made a promise, correct. But think before you do it. Think of the correct, the prices, or what we call nowadays, the checks and the balances. Yiftach wants to do a good thing, but on the other hand, he doesn't have the correct checks and balances. Number two, number six. Number seven, line 153. Hashvi'i, the seventh thing. Hulodia. Shemi shenadar l'ashem. Anybody who makes a profit, yichuyvu lo sheikaimuhu, he has to keep it. Ba'af al pi sheikhabed lo ma'od, even though it might be very, very hard for him. Halo tireh, ki yiftach ba'avur shepatza piv l'ashem, even though he promised this thing to Hashem, huchrach lekayem in nidro, he was forced to do it. Even though it was very hard for him to do it. Yiftach was such a ma'aretz, they didn't know there's a way out of getting out of Nidorim. Answer one, number one, which the Rabbi gives, correct. But Yiftach doesn't know halacha. He doesn't know anything. He just makes promises. He doesn't know that there's a way of getting out of Nadorim. Gam lo yadu ze et ze, echad me'anshei gvulo. Perhaps Yiftach doesn't know Pinchos, which is very hard to say. Why? Let's see why the Ralbag says it. Ki kvar nishka'u kulam benimusei agoyim. Because all that tribe, all the people on the other side of the Jordan, were halfway assimilated. Ve'azvu et ha'Torah yamim rabim.
Right?
Number one is that since they were completely assimilated, and that was one of the big problems of the people on the other side of the Jordan, they didn't know halacha. Therefore, Yiftach doesn't know that he's got to go to Ephraim. Ve'efshar nomar ki b'kiyum zeh ha-neder pirsem ha-nes she'asa lo Hashem itbarach. That because of the neder, because of that, HaKadosh Baruch Hu does the miracle. Bilti ra'ui she'itcharet Yiftach al ha-neder lefi ma she'chashav. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu did such a miracle, Yiftach doesn't want to give up on his neder because he feels that because HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave him the ability to win the war was because of the neder which he does to his daughter. Those are the different explanations which are completely different from what Chazal say. Nothing to do with ego. It's to do with practicalities. Yiftach doesn't know of Menashe, of Pinchas, and Pinchas doesn't get involved. He doesn't know there's a fight there. Each country, each tribe has his own tzarot. That is the perspective of the way of the Ralbag sees it. Next. Line number 160, Rabotai. Hashmini lodia she'ein ra'ui la'adam she'ikane lechavero. Kin'ah, Rabotai. Jealousy. Jealousy, Raboisai. Ephraim were jealous of Menashe. She'igie mimenu po'al tov. K'shelo kara lo basiyato tova. Ha'hu? K'dei she'e nikra'al shmo? That means, Ephraim were jealous of Menashe, of Yiftach, because he won the battle. So therefore, there's jealousy involved. Why is there jealousy? Because Yiftach won. If Yiftach won, that means tribe of Menashe is better than Ephraim. Ephraim come and say, why didn't you call us? K'dei she'nikra'al shmo, gam zeh ha'poel ha'tov, halo tireh. Ki bnei Ephraim hayu mekanim al Yiftach. They were jealous of Yiftach. Shelo kara im lalechet imo. V'kara lifneihem, mipnei zeh, mehara ma shekara. You were jealous. Your jealousy breaks your ideology. It breaks your whole concept. Look what Ephraim does. They were jealous. What happens? They go and fight with that because that the war, Yiftach wins the war. Ephraim come and say, what do you mean? You won the war. We'll teach you a lesson. You should have called us. Ephraim come and fight with Menashe because of that. Jealousy. Just look at it, what Chazal say. Hakin'ah, hata'ava, va'kovod. Ephraim are jealous. Kavod between Ephraim, between Aaron, between Pinchas and Yiftach. Everything plays here, Rabotai. Kina, taiva, and kovod. Plays in this story of Yiftach. And what did Chazal say? Hakin'ah, ta'ava, ba'akavod, motzi'im adam min ha'olam. Break you down. Chi'i. Next one. Lohodia. She'ein ra'ui la'adam, she'e bilti makir hatova she'kibel me'acher. V'igmol ra tachatova. Hakoras hatoiv. What should have really happened here? Ephraim should have shown gratitude to Menashe. Ephraim should have said to Menashe, boy, shkoyach, you saved your tribe. If chas v'chalila Ammon would have conquered Menashe, then they would have gone to Ephraim. No. Ephraim come and say, you should have called us. We're the ones who are important. Ephraim showed no hakarat atov, showed no gratitude to Menashe, to Yiftach. Hachi'i. Lodia, she'ein ra'ui la'adam, she'bilti makir hatova, she'kibel me'acher, v'igmol ra'a tachat tova. Halo tir'e, ki b'nei Ephraim, she'aya lahem la'kir tova, they should have shown gratitude, al yidei Yiftach, v'ligmol lahem chesed ze, al chesed ze, she'chashvu ligmol lahem ra'a tachat tov she'asa, nimshach lahem mehara nifla. Because you didn't show gratitude and you were jealous, what happens to you? You lose 42,000 people because of that. Rabbi, take the whole story of Yiftach. All of the human psyche takes over in this story. That means there's nothing to do with Emunah here. If we look at this story in a Dickens way or in a Victor Hugo way, then it's all about Shakespeare. It's a human psyche. Nothing to do with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's to do with midot. There are no midot. There are no deep mannerisms of ways of behavior. And that's why this story of Yiftach becomes so vital in the world of midot, derech eretz, how you've got to relate to one another. Kin'ah, ta'ava v'kavod, the last one. Asiri, hulodia. She'ein ra'ui lebalei hayecholet legalot leganot hachalushim. People who have got power should not downtrod and make into shmatas the ordinary people. She'ein ra'ui lebal hayecholet leganot hachalushim. Halo tireh, ki ebnei Ephraim hayu korim gilad plitei Ephraim al tzad abuz, va'even shemasu haita l'rosh pina, v'kiyaka et binyana machazak. What happened here? Menashe feel they are now stronger than Ephraim. And what do? They take all these prisoners of war, and what do? They slaughter them. No reason. No reason at all. You should have sent the people of Ephraim who were living. You came to fight with us. Nachon, we've got the right. But once they run away and they become refugees amongst the tribe, what should you do? Send them back home. They're from the same people. No, Rabboisai. What does Menashe do? Slaughters them. Here, Rabotai, says the Ralbag, five pieces of Musa. Five teachings, which every single part of this story tells you how the human psyche works. So this story of Yiftach is an unbelievable insight into the way people behave. If you remember the story of the beginning of Yiftach, Yiftach is thrown out of his family. Why? Because he wasn't a member of the Yichus. He wasn't a member of the high clan. Therefore, he gets thrown out of his family. He then becomes a leader of the gangs, of the mafia. Then the people feel they need to take over, etc., etc., etc. This, Rabotai, the story of Yiftach, is a Shakespearean story. And the mitzvah is how to analyze and learn from the story of Yiftach all the different lessons which Chazal teach us. Kin'ah, ta'ava, kavod, looking after people, derech eretz, how you look after people in the time of trouble, etc., etc. You don't throw out from your family. The first sin begins in the family of Yiftach. He gets thrown out because he's not part of the hierarchy of the family. Therefore, he gets thrown out. And then comes the people running towards him because he's the only one who can take over. So the head of the mafia becomes the leader. The minute the head of the mafia becomes the leader, he hasn't got the ability to see things in the correct way. He might be a great, what's it called? A great warrior. On the other hand, he does stupid things in the way of life. And therefore he makes a neder. He doesn't think straight because he's never been taught to think straight. Why hasn't he been taught to think straight? Because he's thrown out of his family. And the minute a person's thrown out of his family, then automatically he doesn't have the correct education of caring about people. Therefore, the first sin is, in actual fact, the father. The father of this family, the head of the tribe of Yiftach, he's the actual fact guilty one. He's the one who's guilty because he doesn't educate Yiftach in the correct way. If he doesn't educate Yiftach in the correct way, then automatically what happens? What happens is that his son becomes the head of the mafia. The head of the mafia doesn't know how to think properly. Since he doesn't know how to think properly, therefore he becomes the head and he's got to deal with Pinchas, he's got to deal with this, he's got to deal with the other. That, Rabboisai, is the story of Yiftach. Fascinating insight into ethics. Fascinating insight in how to see, how to look at people in a correct way. How covet plays, how taiva plays, how jealousy plays. Rabboisai, if anybody wants to ask any questions, now, please do. You can take down your microphones. Questions? Now, I can't. סליחה, אתה שומע?
כן.
אתה יכול להוריד את הרמקולים מכולם כי רוצים לשאול.
שנייה אחת. טוב, אצל כולם רמקולים פתוחים, בבקשה.
Right, questions. One by one, one by one.
Oh, that's lovely. That's very nice.
אני חושב שזה לא ילך ככה, אני אסגור אצל כולם, מי שרוצה לשאול שאלה שיקליק על רייז הנד, שירים את היד, כי אחרת אנחנו לא נוכל לעשות את זה.
אני לא רואה את כולם, שנייה, שנייה, שנייה.
אתה שומע אותי? אתה לא צריך, רק תגיד להם שמי שרוצה שיקליק על רייז הנד, להרים יד, ואז אני אפתח לו מיקרופון, כי אנחנו לא נשאיר.
בבקשה, כל מי שרוצה לשאול שאלה...
איפה אתה
עולה? טוב.
אני סגרתי את כולם, אבל כל מי שרוצה לדבר, הוא יכול לפתוח את המיקרופון שלו.
בסדר. She comes out bad in the story.
Yeah.
I agree with you. She's the sacrifice in the story. Okay? But there are many stories like that. Okay? Unfortunately, there's always a sacrifice to one story to the behavior of people. Okay, Yiftach is a sacrifice of his parents, the way his father, the way he deals with him in the beginning. And that's why he starts that way. Okay, so everybody's a sacrifice of something. Okay, the Chochmah in the world is to minimize all the sacrifices. And unfortunately, she's the sacrifice. You could see she goes to Beis Din. She goes to Pinchas. She goes to everybody. And nobody manages to solve that problem because everybody's blind.
But Hashem leaves it alone.
What? Yeah, but Hashem leaves it 100%. Hashem leaves it alone.
That's
once it's in your hands, and you've got to deal with your own tzoras. Correct. HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't do miracles for people. Stam like that. Malas tot. Okay, it's a lesson for all of us. It's a lesson to how educate, it's a lesson to how you speak, it's a lesson to how you think, it's a lesson for everything. Yeah. Who else?
Shnia, ma anachnu osim?
Me, anybody who wants to lift up your hand to ask a question.
O la'arim yat, o lichtof li be chat, she'em rotzim ledaber, ani iftach.